Hello. Thank you for your purchase of Robin. Robin is a kind of smart and intelligent robot that can keep balance automatically. This is the package of Robin, which includes company information and some basic notes. This is the serial number of the product, which is the same with the one in the car body. This is the color mark of the product. After ensuring the perfectness of the package, please open it. Be sure with proper strength to avoid the scratches of the inner components. Take out the upper interior and inspect if all spare parts in the package are completed. The following spare parts are included in the package of Robin. Products manuals. Charger. Bag of tools. Bag of screws. Two wireless keys. Handlebar grip. Car body. Steering rod. Firstly, put the steering rod into the adapter. Make sure the mark of our company is in the front of the rod. And tighten it up by 4 screws. Secondly, put the handlebar grip into the adapter of the steering rod and tighten it up with the 4M5 screws. Please take notice with the direction of the handle grip. Now, the installation of Robin is completed. After the installation of Robin, please unlock the locking wrench in the middle of the steering rod and adjust the height of it. Finally, screw it up again. After adjustment, press the power open button. Behind the body of Robin to turn it on. Now, we're going to introduce some important components of Robin to you. Robin consists of the handle grip, steering rod, and the car body. You can control the direction of Robin with the handle grip and the steering rod, but the power and controlling part are set from the main car body of Robin. There are 2 pedals in the car body. There are 4 sensors under the pedals. Only when the foot of users stands up on one of them can Robin enter into the work model and adjust to the balance model automatically. On the top of the car body, there is display board of electrical quantity and 3 indicator lights. Under normal model, all 5 lights will keep brightening when the power is sufficient. When the green indicator light is shining, it means the system is under a normal state. Vice versa, the system will be powered off when it indicates that there is something wrong with the system. When the red indicator light is on, it means the system goes wrong. The indicator light of the Bluetooth will be shining when the connection with the computer is down. The charging port of Robin is behind the car body. Open the hinge so you can see the electric power port and the button. Please close the hinge when Robin's at work. This is the wireless key of Robin. You can make a control of it within 10 meters. There are four buttons on the wireless key, which are the beginner button, power on button, login button, normal power on button and power off button, from top to bottom. The beginner button, when the system is under power off model, press this button so you can enter into the beginner model, which speed limit is within 7 km per hour. Normal power on button. When Robin is power off, you can turn it on by pressing this button and enter the normal model with speed limit of 15 km per hour. Power off button. Press this button and Robin will be power off. Press the beginner button and normal power on button for 5 seconds. Robin will enter into the program of self-check-in system. During self-check-in, bumming sound from the Robin can be heard and the LED lights keep flickering. Meanwhile, the two wheels will turn on automatically in a slow speed. The system will recover when everything is right. Otherwise, warning sound of the beeping will come from the buzzer and it will turn off automatically. Under this condition, Robin cannot be started before the faults are removed and should be sent to the appointed station for repair and maintenance. After a general knowledge of the basic components, now we can operate it. If it is the first time to start up the robot, press the button on the rear cover of Robin. Robin can be turned on and off with the wireless key after the first usage. If you don't use it for a long time, please press the button in the rear cover to start Robin again. Press the power on button to start Robin. If the indicator light keeps flickering, it means Robin's under normal function. Firstly, put one foot on the pedal gently. After a sound of tick, put the other foot on it. Keep yourself balanced and Robin will stand motionless. Lean your body forward or backward to a small extent, so it will move forward or backward accordingly. Swing the handlebar left or right, Robin turns left or right respectively. Before getting off from Robin, you should keep it static and balanced first, then one foot off first, then the other one. After getting off from Robin, it will keep balanced for 1 second. After it is not balanced, put it towards back gently and make it stop. Press the power off button on the wireless key to shut it down. If you want to leave Robin for a while, you can purchase a special lock and lock it with other fixed articles for your car's safety. Make the lock rope around the fixed article and make the cylinder go through the ring of the other side of the lock. Insert the bolt of the cylinder into the plug of Robin's lock and spin the key. Make sure to tighten it up. when opening it. Put the key into the cylinder and spin to make the bolt retreat. Take the cylinder back and untie the lock rope. At last, take the lock back. When the display board shows that the power is not sufficient, the robin needs to be charged. Plug one side of the charger into the standard socket. And the other side into the charging port of robin. Pay attention not to mix up the direction of the plug-in. When the red indicator lights on, the charger of robin turns green. It means the complement of charging. Thank you for watching this video, which can help you to operate it correctly. You can share more information in user's manual.